friends, welcome to Ranjini's Notes. This is our 85th episode of Ranjini's Notes, and in this video we are going to learn the very important technique every vainika should learn, gamakas. What are gamakas? Gamakas are the embellishments that we do to swaras. The beautification or the ornamentation of swaras are gamakas. This is very, very important, especially for veena players to know, because veena is the closest instrument for vocal. So whatever we sing in our throat, we can exactly copy that on veena if we know how to play gamaka techniques. There are 15 type of gamakas on veena. In fact, more than 15 we could say. But in this video, I am going to tell you the two most important gamakas that we normally use for any beginners or for other gamaka techniques. The first and foremost gamaka is the wavy gamaka. What is a wave? A wave is combination of two notes in one place. For example, when I sing Maya Malava Gaula Arohanam, Sa re ga ma pa da ni sa, this is direct notes. This is how we learn when we learn the beginning. This is how we would have learnt when we start our lessons without any gamakas. But once we progress from initial lessons to Geetam or Varnam, it is very, very important to learn how to play with gamakams. So the first and foremost, as I said earlier, wavy gamakam for Maya Malava Gaula, because it changes from ragam to ragam. So for Maya Malava Gaula, since we have Sa Re 1 and same way Pa Da 1, so both Re and Da should be played on the previous notes. So this is Sa. Play this wavy gamaka. Let us take a closer look. Sa re, that re we are oscillating in sa. So this is sa, that is same as ma position on the second string. So when we pull that sa, we can clearly see this is re. We should not pull too much. When we pull too much, we will get into Re 2. So we need to figure out where exactly we get that Re 1 sound. Sa Re, Sa Re. Sa Re, Re 3. So we need to figure out where exactly we get Re 1 for Maya Malava Gaula. Sa Re. So we need to pull only to that level so that we don't go beyond Re 1. Sa Re, Sa Re, Sa Re, Sa. So I am plucking only for first note Sa, and then rest I am just sustaining that vibration. Okay, to get that wavy sound. Same way, pa da. So here also we need to figure out where exactly we get da one sound. If I go beyond that, this is wrong. We can give a very mild pull, that is enough for Maya Malava Gaula Da 1. Pada. So where do we use this gamaka? We use on all, even playing movie songs also, we use this wavy gamaka. For just to give you an example, in the Tamil song, Poongadave song, Tananana ra ra ra. So here we can see that wavy gamaka we use. Or if we also take another song, Kannana Kanne, Kannana Kanne, En Meedhu Saayava. So here, for giving that wavy sound, we use this wavy gamaka. That's about wavy gamaka. So the second gamaka that we are going to see in this video is the sliding gamaka. So when we say sliding, the sliding can be just before the note that we want to play, or 2-3 notes previous to the note that we have to play. Sliding gamaka is very, very important because it also applies to the other gamakas. So once we learn this technique, it will be helpful to learn the other gamakas as well. So when we do the sliding, it is very important that we slide only from the note which is in that raga. For example, when we take Mayamalava Gaulai, Sa, Sa can be played from open Pa. I am playing from the second string, open. This is Pa, right? So just pluck the note and then keep the sustain to slide to Sa. Like that. Or we can also play from Da 1. But it is very important that we don't play the other notes which is not in the ragam. So we should not start from Da 2. Not like this. We can either start from Da 1 or from Panchamam. Re, I'm taking from Da. So we have to pluck in that note and go to the land in the note which we have to play. So when I say Re, I am plucking in Da and sustaining that vibration to reach Re. So Ma, I am playing from Re 1, I am plucking in Re and going to Ma. So where do we apply this sliding gamaka? In fact, we apply the sliding gamaka even while playing movie songs. I am just taking the first line of Kannamuchi Ennada. So in this first line itself, we have applied the sliding gamaka many times. So if we observe carefully, Sa ni da ma, that Sa itself we are sliding from Da. Ma ma ri ga ma. Sa ma ma ga ma, Sa ma. I am sliding from Sa. Da, da, sa. So in this first line itself, we have applied the sliding gamakas in many places. So it's very important to practice. Just we can practice from lower notes. Mm-hmm. is how we play Shankarabharanam with the sliding gamaka technique. I hope this video is helpful to you. We will be learning more gamaka techniques and tutorials in the following episodes. So kindly subscribe to my page if you have not done to get further updates about my videos. If you find it useful, kindly pass it on to your friends and family who are learning Veena or any other instrument on classical bass, and I hope it is useful for them as well. Thank you.